Hi, and welcome to the MVAC lab. I'm research intern Cindy Kutchick. Among the stone tools we find at archaeological sites are implements used for drilling holes in a variety of materials, even hard types of stone. Today, we feature a special guest, UWL archaeology student Louden Ferguson, to tell us more about them. Louden provides an overview of stone tool use and talks about studying drills through Usewear and Microwear analyses for senior thesis research. We hope you enjoy this dive into drills. And don't forget to use the timestamps in the description box to jump to a specific section.
Hi, my name is Louden Ferguson, and I am a graduating senior in the archaeology program at the University of Wisconsin-La Crosse. I'm currently finishing my senior thesis research on lithic drill usewear. Drills are a type of specialized stone tool used for the same things we use drills for today, making holes in different materials. While drills are relatively uncommon, at least a few are present at almost all indigenous archaeological sites and have been used in the upper Midwest for thousands of years. While they can be many different shapes, most are in an iconic T shape or present as straight drill bits.
Drills are generally used in one of three ways: hand drills, hafted, or with a bow drill. Hand drilling requires a larger drill and, as you can see, takes significantly more effort for less effect.
Meanwhile, using a drill hafted like this allows you to roll it between your hands or against your thigh to allow it to rotate faster with less effort. The drills may have been hafted in several different ways, but most likely they used deer sinew. This is a modern experimental example of what a drill hafted with deer sinew may have looked like.
The third type of drill is a bow drill, which is more effective than the other two due to its ability to reach a higher rate of rotation while also being less strenuous. Due to the organic materials used in constructing a bow drill, however, very few examples have preserved in the archaeological record, and how much they were used is unknown.
There are a few different reasons to use drills. Some may have been used on soft materials such as hides. This kind of tool is generally called a perforator, which is closely related to a drill. Drills were often used for harder materials such as shell, wood, or bone, which could be turned into tools themselves or into decorative artifacts. A technique used to make drills more efficient in drilling holes in harder materials is by using grit or sand in the initial divot to provide greater friction from the drill. How do we know how these drills were used, though? Stone drills like these have been observed historically, but two techniques that focus on determining tool use are known as Usewear and Microwear analysis, which are the focuses of my own research. Usewear and Microwear analysis are closely related but slightly different techniques. Both use a microscope to take images of the surface of stone tools to analyze how different patterns accumulated as they were used. Usewear analysis is carried out at lower levels of magnification, generally around 20 times to 100 times. It looks for microscopic flakes that came off the stone of the tool as it was used. The primary purpose of this analysis is to determine whether a tool was used or not. Two advantages of usewear analysis are that it is quick to perform and relatively easy to learn. Microwear analysis, on the other hand, uses higher levels of magnification, generally from 200 times to 500 times. It is more difficult and takes longer to perform, but it is able to find information that lower magnification analysis cannot, such as markings called striations and polishes that develop from a tool being used on specific material. Using these techniques, my thesis research found evidence that most drills made by the Oneota people of the La Crosse locality, a late pre-contact group occupying the modern La Crosse area, were likely hafted for use.
Many thanks to Louden for shedding light on drills. It's always exciting to see the hard work and excellent research UWL archaeology students put into their senior thesis projects. And we hope you've enjoyed this small glimpse. For more information, see the description box. And to further explore archaeological topics, find links to MVAC social media, and view and subscribe to our monthly e-news, check out the MVAC website. You can also donate online to support MVAC's work, including our videos. Thanks for watching.